Hi guys, David and David here from Payette4.com, and in this video we're going to explain what to do when your iPhone's camera isn't working.
Now, if you're a teenage girl, calm down. It's going to be okay. And that goes for everybody else
who
takes photos too. So,
the camera app's a built-in app. It can run into software issues or hardware problems,
right.
So don't automatically assume that it's broken.
And you need a new phone.
Right.
So the best thing to do is to start by troubleshooting the software. This is what they do at the Apple Store as well. So, let's open up the camera app.
Sure, let's open it up.
Yep.
It's now open.
It is. Well, David's camera is working.
Yeah. Pretend it's not working.
Pretend it's not. Yep. So let's say you open up the camera app and it's black. Now, David has a little story about this.
I do. So I had a friend in college. She wanted me to take some pictures for her.
Mm-hmm.
I took two. They were completely black and she got mad and she left.
Right.
Next day she comes back to me and she says, "I'm so sorry I got mad at you yesterday. I had my case on upside down. And that's why, you know, the case was actually blocking her camera."
And so did you guys start dating after that happened?
No, I told her to go to hell.
Sounds like the right move to me.
Yep.
Okay. Next step, are you using a third-party camera app? So if you're using one of the other apps in the App Store, a lot of the times the software isn't as robust or well-coded as the Apple apps are.
And we've actually used some third-party camera apps in the past. We found that the built-in camera app is just significantly better in pretty much every single way.
Yep.
So if you're using a third-party camera app, you might just want to delete it and use the built-in camera app.
Right. And if you have more than one third-party camera app on your phone, and you love taking pictures, open up each, you know, more than one app. Mm-hmm. If you're having the problem in more than one app, then it is, you know, either a software or hardware problem and not just an app specific problem. Mm-hmm. So, next step.
Well, let's close out of all of our apps because if, you know,
sort of
we
basic,
just said.
Yeah, basic troubleshooting for software.
Mm-hmm. So, iPhone 8 and earlier, double press the home button, app switcher will appear, swipe the app up and off the screen.
Mm-hmm.
I'll just do all of my apps real quick. Look at that. All gone. They're all closed.
Pretty good.
iPhone 10, it's a little bit different.
Right. So what you got to do is, excuse me, swipe up from the very bottom of the screen and hold it there with your finger.
Yep.
And then press and hold until you see the red minus sign in the upper left-hand corner of the app, and then you can swipe them right off the
top of
the
screen. Or you can probably tap that red minus button,
You can, but that's no fun.
All right, if you say so.
Yeah, you can miss.
So you just closed out all your apps, reopened the camera app. Is it working now? If it's not, why don't we try restarting your iPhone real quick? Could be more of an iPhone-wide minor software
glitch
or something.
Right.
Press and hold the power button.
Mm-hmm.
Slide the power off will appear.
Yep.
Slide it. Your iPhone's
turn it off and back on.
Pretty simple stuff.
Takes a real good technician to tell you to turn it off and back on.
Seriously.
Okay. Next step, reset all settings.
Yep.
So reset all settings is a good sort of intermediate software troubleshooting step because it doesn't delete any of your personal data, like your pictures, but it does reset everything in the settings app. And a lot of the time software problems can occur when something gets corrupted in there. So this is sort of the first line of defense that if you go to the Apple Store, they probably will say, "Hey, let's reset all settings on your phone."
Sure. So let's open up the settings app. Scroll down to general. Tap reset.
Yep.
Tap reset all settings.
Yep.
Enter your iPhone passcode.
Really secure.
If you have a restrictions passcode set up, you'll probably need to
David's mom doesn't want him to be looking at certain things. So
right, exactly.
You know,
so you enter your restrictions passcode, confirmation pop-up appears on the screen. And just tap reset all settings. Your iPhone will turn off. The reset will be performed.
Performed.
And then your iPhone will turn back on.
Okay.
Now, when you reset all settings, you know, stuff like your Wi-Fi passwords will just be gone. You're going to have to write those down, and you'll have to enter them again afterwards.
Right, since we already, but you've already done this, so now you're just mad at us.
Yeah, you've already
done the
reset.
Yeah. Next step, DFU restore. So this is the last line of software defense before we decide it's a hardware problem. So
it's the goalie.
It is. It's the goalie of the whatever sports. So a DFU restore is the deepest type of restore. It's important to do a DFU restore because it addresses firmware issues, which is the F in the DFU.
And we'll link to
camera
that.
Camera has firmware. Yep.
Yeah, we got a great DFU video. Walk through the whole process. We'll link to that in the card up above and in the description section below.
Mm-hmm.
If you perform the DFU restore, you open your camera app. It's still not working.
Still black.
Maybe real quick, just, you know, wipe off the camera lens. I don't know. Maybe
we tried that in the beginning.
Dropped it in oil or something. I don't know.
Yep, dropped in oil.
But if your camera lens is fine, repair.
Repair.
It's time to get it repaired.
It is. So, a couple different options. If your iPhone is under warranty, not damaged, take it to the Apple Store. They do camera repairs usually.
We also recommend a Pulse, a third-party repair service. I'll send a tech right to you. Repairs your iPhone on the spot. Lifetime warranty on that repair.
Cheaper than Apple on that repair. And they give us a commission, so, yeah.
We'll link to both the Apple Store and Pulse in the description.
But they really are the best option for a lot of people. They come to you. You don't have to stand around in line for hours.
It takes,
go to the mall.
For a lot of people, going to the Apple Store is a day-long event because you drive to the mall.
It was for me.
Yeah.
Like every other, but I worked there, so I guess that makes sense.
It's a little bit different for you.
Yeah.
So that is what to do when your iPhone camera isn't working. Thank you guys for watching the video. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click that little notification bell. You'll get an immediate alert every time we upload a new video.
And who doesn't want that?
I do. I want that.
Yeah, well,
you do too.
Yep.